We are all one. We are all one spirit. So we're all equal. We're all equal, actually. There's no higher or lower in reality. So we're all friends, actually. We're all equal friends. This is a fact. Even the great, great teachers, actually, we're equal with them. We're equal friends. We're friends with them. We are friends with the greatest teachers, all of them. It's just that we're trying to have a relationship with something higher. And so we don't realize where we are. Where we are. We think that we're extending beyond reality. And so we don't realize that we're not extending beyond reality. we're just in reality. And so all spirit is one great friendship, one family, actually. We all belong, the truth is, we all belong to just one family. One family. So, I've taken the time to remember this friendship and be reminded of it by some friends. Now, these teachers are friends of mine. I consider them my friends. And I have three friends that I'm particularly familiar with. And people would say, well, these are great teachers. And I say, well, they're actually great friends. You know how the song goes, what a friend we have in Jesus. It's true. Jesus is actually our friend, telling us, hey, there's nothing to reach beyond reality. You're reaching. You think that you're making this big reach and nothing's happening. You're not reaching anywhere. There's nowhere to reach to, but you can't reach beyond reality. You cannot reach beyond reality. So just remember where you are. Just remember where you are. Remember you're dwelling with your one family. We're all just one family. One family. One family. One family. So Here's a friend. This is the fisherman, the ultimate fisherman, Jesus of Nazareth. And Jesus is a great friend. Jesus is a great friend. Great friend, great friend, great friend. But we tend to hold Jesus in awe, saying, wow, Jesus, you must have discovered what's beyond reality. That's why you're so high and mighty. And so, can you help us? Can you help us? Can you help us? And he said, no, I didn't discover anything. I didn't discover. I just know there's nothing beyond reality you can reach. So just realize where you are. Realize where you are. Now, another great friend is, most people don't know who this is. This is Longchenpa. Longchenpa is a great friend of all of us, actually, as is Jesus. Longchenpa is his last appearance here, a Tibetan from Tibet area, and one of the great, great, great revered spiritual teachers in the history of the planet. But when I was approached by Longchenpa, it wasn't as here I am, I'm some great teacher. It was just a friend, just unassuming, natural, unassuming. I heard you want some help. I'm here to help. Great. I said, great. They don't see themselves as somehow greater than us. They know they're equal. There's all one family of perfect equality and spirit, perfect freedom. Now, one more great friend. Great friend, great friend. This is Sri Anandamayi Ma, who knows herself. She says, please see me as your friend. Please see me as your friend. Okay. Please see me as your friend. So these are the friends that I've hung out with in my life. I prefer their company to, you know, the people of the world, the people of the dualistic misadventure. They're very sane. They're completely sane. And what they say, oh yeah, that's sanity. That's right. And we're very much insane in terms of dualistic notions of higher and lower, lesser and greater, over there, here, over there, bigger, you know, just more important, less important, wiser, stupider, all these dualistic, polarities and everything in between. This is just part of our dream of trying to reach something beyond God. And we think we're going through all sorts of troubles and difficulties. We think, well, that's the price we have to pay to succeed at this. So these three friends, I have these three friends, three major friends. And I say, friends, why don't you come visit sometime? Why don't you come visit a friend? Why not? What are they going to say that is so startling? That's the right question. What can they say that would startle anybody, really? Or for me, like, what something that would startle me? Well, I already know what they're going to say. So why don't we allow our friends to visit us is the question. Why don't we allow our friends to visit us here? We should. Again, they do not see themselves as above us. We're the ones who see ourselves as above them. Okay, this is a fact. We believe that we're above them. Okay. But then we backtrack. So, well, we're a long ways. We're on a path that's taking us above you, but we're far away from actually being above you, but we're on this path. Well, that just shows the desire to be above them, doesn't it? It does show the desire to be above. That's the intent. So if the intent's there, that's the purpose, that's the intent. It's just a fact that we cannot get higher than God. But the intent is there to get higher than God. So if you feel you're lesser than, that's because your intent is to be greater than. Okay? If you feel you're lesser than God, your intent is to be greater than God. If you feel you're lesser than allness, that means you want to be greater than allness. So our so-called little status here as little bodies on this planet is just an expression that we want to be greater than everything. That's the pits of duality, isn't it? You think it's going to result in some marvelous, wonderful, you know, but it really results in hell, because you have to play this lesser than role just so you can get a contrast and believe in something greater. So we make ourselves like almost virtually insignificant. I remember I made myself into like total mental chaos to try to think that I could be some more perfect than perfect, that kind of thing, more perfect than perfect. So my three friends here are simply, they're not doing that. They're not trying to be more than they are. And so they're not less than they are either. You see that? They're not less than they are because they're not trying to be more than they are. That's the only difference there is we're simply trying to be more than they are. And since we can't, the only way we can play this out is by being less than they are. And then believing that because we're less, that means there must be the category of more. Except there isn't. So we're trapped in less. We feel trapped in less than. The only way out is to give up the desire to be more than. More than. Now, why would we want to be more than these great teachers here? Great teachers, great friends. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful friends. This is Jesus in his completely happy, perfectly happy, you know, blissful state. He's not all weepy. Jesus is not some weepy person. On a weepy expression. You know, it's pure happiness. And so here's another of our great friends. And these are the ones who are simply not trying to be more than what they are. And so there's no less at all. And if there's no more and less, you have purity. Purity. You can't get any more pure than these three friends, Longchenpa, Sri Anandamayima, and Jesus Christ. You cannot get more pure than that. Three are absolutely pure. Absolutely pure. Because there's not an iota of desire on any of their parts to be greater than perfect purity. So we just let this sink in. The trouble we have, if we try to be in their presence, is we need to come down, saying what, you know, we think that we're so much lower than them, but our attitude is really prideful, like we're better than them, potentially. See, potentially we think we're better than them. This is the trick that we play in our minds, is potential. Does reality need potential? Potential implies time, space, process, more, less. So we really have to be repentant, humble and repentant in. Get off our high horse, as it were. If we want to be visited by our friends, we can't be having this attitude that, you know, we're greater than they are. Because then we say, well, we're too busy for you. We're busy becoming better than you. So we think, oh, you know, I cannot relate to Jesus because he's so much greater. But actually our attitude is, I don't want to relate to Jesus because I feel I'm going to be better. I'm greater than Jesus, and I don't want to be pulled back into that lower state. That's the secret attitude that we have. And if we can just be honest about that, that opens the door, you see. So, I'm telling you, we have a superiority complex here. It's hidden. It's hidden. Everybody who thinks they're a body has a superiority complex. We think we're better than this. And this is coming out in this modern culture, isn't it? It's coming out. They stop pretending that, you know, there's no false humility. They're just saying, hey, we're greater than, you know, what do you need these people, Jesus, for? I mean, we're way better than Jesus. That's their attitude. You can tell, right? It's out in the open now. They're unrepentant. It's an unrepentant generation, unrepentant time. They brush off these teachers. You know, it's like, that was fine back then. They say it was fine back then, but we've evolved past that. I have this caption here on. Our pure, pure, pure friend. And it says, well, it says historical. You cannot be deleted from history. I said, you cannot be deleted from history. You cannot be deleted from history. But the world is taking an attitude of like, oh yeah, you know, she's a very nice, nice teacher back there in India. But come on, internet, computers, this cyber society, you know, we've moved beyond that. We've moved beyond that. And so what's happening is a lot of people in the world, everybody has got this feeling like, hey, I'm not sure. Can we move beyond this? Is Jesus someone we move beyond? Or is that a sign of our spiritual pride, saying we're trying to be better than God, actually? So I would say, if you can admit your superiority complex to these teachers, this is how you can actually relate with them finally. That's how I'm looking at it. I've been visited by all three of these friends, and so I'm aware that they're happy to visit with us, actually. They're happy to visit with us. Why not? We're their dear friends. We're part of their one family. They were family to them. I'm telling you that. We are family. And it's a terrible thing for us to be locking out these family members, actually. We're locking them out, to tell you the truth. We got things backwards. We think, oh, Jesus, you're so high, you're so mighty, you're so great, you would never condescend to talk with me. No, it's actually the opposite. We think we're so high and we're so mighty that we should never condescend to talk to Jesus. That's a fact. And if we can get to that fact and admit it, again, door can open. Just say, Jesus, I really apologize, you know, for locking you out. We keep thinking that we gotta open the door, you know, to Jesus. No, we got the door locked. We got our doors locked to Jesus. Because we say, Jesus, we don't want to let you in. Because we're better than you. It's an embarrassment. We don't want to be reminded of the past, you know. We've moved on from that. So we got our doors locked. We're keeping Jesus out. So we need to apologize to Jesus, actually. Saying, Jesus, I'm very, very sorry. I'm extremely regretful, actually, that I've kept my door closed to you all this time. Now, I've taken a few peeks. You know, I've opened the door a little bit and closed it. Open the door, who's there? Knock, 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 knock. Jesus, open up. Oh, yeah, what do you want? Huh? Close it again. Now they've knocked at my door, so, you know, they'll come knock. If they know you will open the door a little bit, they'll come knocking. And say, you knock, 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 knock. And, yeah, who is it? It's your friend. Your friend, yeah, okay. Oh, Jesus, whoa, you know. I'm not sure I want to let you in. I'm not sure I want to let you in. You don't want to be greater than God, you know. I'm in the process of going beyond you. I don't want to disturb that process, is what we say. Right? We don't want to disturb that process. Now, it's a heavy thing to realize you've been locking these friends out. You know, I'm feeling it, you know, remorse. I thought they weren't visiting me. No, the thing is, I had my door closed. I had my door locked. And just, you know, the stupidity, the deprivation that we're experiencing because of this. Because these are the ones that know the totality of the one family. And they'll tell us about it. And they said, hey, you know, got some great good news for you. We're all this one super, super fantastic family. Yeah. Oh, you know, I feel stupid when I open it, you know, just like, wow, how stupid was that? That was really stupid. That was just terrible. But that's what repentance means, is to recognize you've been on an ego trip, you've been on a superiority trip, and you've been locking out God, been locking out spirit, been locking out your one family. So if one is associating with these great teachers, it's not because they're on some, think they're better than others, it's just the opposite. They've finally dropped their superiority complex. That's what really happens. And then just says, hey, Jesus, I'm not superior to you, you know. And, I'm really regretful, you know, that I took that position for so long. But thank you for, you know, hanging in there. Hope you can forgive me for that. And of course, they say, oh, they understand. So what we're doing is turning things right side up, because we have it upside down. The whole world says, oh, we're not getting any help. We're not getting any help. How come the teachers don't respond to us and all this stuff? Because we have our doors locked. That's why. And in fact, we love to call upon help, 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 and have no help. And then we say, ah, see? 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 They're unable to help me because I'm beyond them now. They're incapable of dealing with my issues, you know, they're incapable. Because I got real issues here. I got the issues of becoming greater. You know, so, of course, we call upon them and get no response, and that feeds our spiritual ego. Now, of course, they wouldn't respond to me. I'm way better than they are. Probably feel so inferior to me they couldn't respond. That's the secret meta message that's buried in duality. Okay? Duality is very tricky. The secret message buried in this lowly condition we're in. Here we are in this piece of flesh, sitting in some dirt, you know, and dying. And so incredibly lowly. The secret meta message is our belief that we're going to be greater than God. That's the secret meta message of it all. So you see these great teachers, they're dwelling in spirit now. They're not trying to be greater than what they are, so there's no motive for them to be lesser either. To try and generate this false polarity of lesser and greater, as if lesser has to imply greater. It doesn't. There's nothing greater than God. We can play the game of being lesser, but it doesn't generate a greater than. See, duality doesn't generate its opposite pole, but we're hoping it does, actually. So instead of calling upon these great teachers in a state of like, oh, you know, you're so wonderful, you're so great, you know, can you please help little old me and stuff, be repentant and say, I'm so severely regretful and sorry that I have, you know, had this superiority complex and I kept my door locked to you. And I'm very ashamed of that, you know, very ashamed to have done this. And I just hope you can stand to even relate to me at all, you know, after, you know, me having this attitude towards you. And you know, just apologize to them, you know, have this attitude of repentance and apology. Remorse, repentance, remorse, humility, saying, wow. You know, at least if you be honest with them, then, you know, there's respect there. You see, if you're honest, say, look, I've been pretending to be greater than you, and that's why, and that's, I still have some of that, you know, complex going, right? And I hope you can work with that a little bit and help me, you know, shed that, because it really is something terrible, you know, don't like it at all. That's how we make contact with these friends of ours, these wonderful brothers and sisters of ours in the one family, actually. This the one, we are all one family. I have seen this, I've experienced it. There's just one family, and we're all it. There isn't some second family, I'm telling you. There is not some second family. We are it. We are it. But we think that they constitute some second family. They do not. They're part of the one family. It is we're trying to constitute a second family, actually. We're trying to be greater than God. This is so. You know, the world's got it wrong. The world's got it wrong. We think that the more lowly we pretend to be, and the more we kowtow and worship, say, oh, you're so wonderful, you're so high up there, and we're so little, nothing's here, and can you please have just a shred of mercy upon this, you know, wretched, lowly person and all this. We think that's the way to get them to respond. No, it doesn't get them to respond. That's an ego trip on our part. It's an ego trip. Just meet them, be straight, honest, meet them equal. Say, okay, you are my equal. I'm sorry I was playing this trip that I was your better. You know? And of course, we have, you know, overtone, vestiges of this. You know, it doesn't just, you know, just, well, it'd be nice if we could just shed it all at one time. But at least we can at least consciously approach it this way. And then we'll get a response. We'll get a response. I've had responses. I've had responses from these friends, from these brothers and sisters of our one family, which doesn't have any second. Reality is one family, and we're it. That's the great news. And we're all equal members of this family. So I'm just praying that I can take this attitude. You know, I'm trying to take this attitude. It's funny, because accepting them as equals is how you will get relate with them and have a connection, is accepting them as equals. Because we're the ones who are trying to pull rank on them. And I know I've never heard this said anywhere, but I'm telling you, this is very clear to me. We're the ones that are pulling rank on them. And we're saying, you know, you're just not good enough for me. So I don't want to talk with you. I don't want to visit with you because you're really not good enough for me. I'm finding others who, you know, way better. Somebody down the street has got a, you know, it's really cool gaming console, you know, and it's like way better. I got this dumb phone and I'm way better. Got one of those, Jesus? You know, got one of those? Oh, you don't, see? I want to hang out with archaicness, you know? Come on. This is the attitude of the prideful ones, and you can feel it in the world. The pridefulness of the world is so incredibly intense. They think they're superior to Jesus, for sure. That's what they believe. In fact, they think they're so superior that even thinking about Jesus is kind of like some ancestor, you know, that came from the boondocks or something, and you don't want to even talk about him, you know, from the swamp. And now you're on Nob Hill, and you kind of want to write that ancestor out of your history, right? Never happened. Very, skeleton in the closet, and it's like, oh my gosh, five generations ago, my family was in a cabin in some swamp. Now I don't want to think about that. Let's just expunge that. Let's just delete that from history. Delete that from history, right? Let's delete that from history. That's the attitude of the world. Let's just delete all of that. Let's just delete Jesus. You know, it's an embarrassment to us now, kind of the black sheep of the family who didn't understand how magnificent we really were going to become. He was just kind of a nice guy, you know, back then, but he didn't understand, you know, that when now we got computers, oh my gosh. I just feel if we can be honest about this, we might start to be able to manage some relationship. Could manage some connection. And just say, hey, the problem with the connection is me, is a superiority complex on my part. So can you help me out, you know, whittle that down enough so I can, you know, get a connection here? Because I need to be reminded of the one family, our one family. I need to be reminded of that. I keep thinking there's some other family that we're all kind of rehearsing to be part of. Like we're all definitely trying to really get into the attitude and mood of we're going to join some other family that's even greater. That's why we're all acting so weird here, actually. It's a very weird place, this world now. Always has been, hasn't it? Rehearse, let's say Jesus comes to you in your consciousness. Just say, Jesus, I want to really apologize so much for pretending to be greater than you. And if you could help me shed that, you know, burden, I'd be very grateful. Sri Nanamayama, I'm very, very saddened that I've, you know, been pretending to be greater than you for so long, and so I would like to let this dissolve away. Can you please help me with that? And Sri and Longchenpa, I'm you know, mortified that I've been pretending to be greater than you when in fact I know we're equal. So can we please get this connection of equality here? Can you help me out with that? Approach them in that way, I'm suggesting. Approach, well, whoever you want to approach, you feel is the great, you know, super helpful, right? Approach them that way, that you're the one with a superiority complex. That's the problem. Not inferiority, no. That's a trick. That's a disguise. It's a superiority complex that we have, actually. Now, this is something that we all see. I guess I'm the first one to say this. I don't know. I hope there's others who have said it. But we all keep thinking, no, we have this inferiority complex. That is not true. It's superiority complex. No question about it. So this is a breakthrough, monumental breakthrough here, when we realize our problem is really a superiority complex. We keep thinking, hey, I can't talk to God. What's the matter? We have a superiority complex to God. We think we've got it nicely hidden, but God's not fooled. God's not fooled at all. So just be honest with God. So we just say, I'm extremely remorseful, I'm extremely remorseful. We don't, you know, attack ourselves or anything. No, that's not honest either. I just say I'm just extremely remorseful that I've been, you know, keeping the door shut to you. Keeping the door shut. It's not what I really want to do. You know, it's just this terrible habit. You know, a terrible habit I have, and could you please help me out with that? So I've had much contact with my family members, you know, that in spirit. But for some reason I keep the door shut here consciously at this level. Because this is the custom here. This is the custom in this world. While in this world we keep the door shut. It's a place where we act out our superiority complexes, actually. So if you're able to look at the world this way, it can revolutionize your viewpoint, for sure. You keep thinking everybody's suffering from problems and inferiorities and we need to raise them up. No, we're suffering from a superiority complex. We need to be brought down, as it were. Yeah, and we look at Jesus and we say, come on, we're beyond that. It's superiority complex. And when we're not honest about that, then we try to hide it by pretending to be inferior. So we get into that feeling like, oh, we're so inferior, we can't possibly talk with you. That's overcompensation to hide the superiority complex. What's Jesus going to say that he hasn't already said? I mean, he's said a lot. And I've read it all in many, many times, and it's like, yeah. Has he got some big secret that he's not telling us? No. No. He's already laid his cards on the table for us. What is he going to say? Well, there's no depth, really, to dreams. There's no real depth. There's no depth at all. There's no reality. Reality is not... does not have any depth to it. The depth is everywhere. There's no layers. There's no levels. There's no layers to reality. There's no levels to it. Reality is everywhere, equally everywhere. There aren't any layers or levels. No layers or levels. No layers or levels. So, yeah, he's going to say that. I always say, yeah, I know, I know that. That's true, yeah. There's no shock. No shock there. I don't feel there's anything that these friends could say that's shocking, really. So then what's the big deal? What's the big deal? You know, we got to get over ourselves. We have a superiority complex. That's the problem. And we pretend not to be able to understand. But what we're really doing is pretending to be superior. You know how the various classes in society, how one class thinks they're superior, they'll pretend to not understand the other class. Like, I don't even know what they're saying. They're so lower than us, we don't even know what they're saying. So we smile and yes, and you know, but... they can't be saying anything important, you know, the hired help or something. But when you get with that hired help, when you get with those lower classes, you know, you listen and you realize they're very intelligent. What is this? Not, I can't understand what they're saying. I can't understand. Of course we can understand, but we pretend, the higher classes pretend that I don't really, you know, I can't understand what they're saying because what they're saying is not intelligent enough for me to understand. So we say, well, I don't understand what you're talking about. Jesus is so difficult. And no, we're taking the superiority complex there and saying Jesus is not able to talk to me coherently because he's lower. That's what's happening. If you really give Jesus a chance and listen to and read and listen to what he says, you'll say, it's perfectly self-evident and I can understand what he's saying. There's no problem there. This is very clear. This is very clear if you give him a chance. So the problem in understanding what Jesus is saying is not because you're lower and you can't understand. It's because you're copying a superiority complex and saying, well, you know, they're not really able to communicate properly with me, you know. So I'm a little bit beyond that right now, and so that's what's happening. That's what's happening. When you drop that, then you can read what Jesus says, and you say, oh, it's crystal clear, no problem at all. It's not because we came up. It's because we came down off our cloud, our superiority complex cloud, and stopped pretending that we couldn't understand, because we're not supposed to understand what those lower than we are saying, because what they're saying couldn't possibly be relevant to us. See, they can't possibly understand our lives, so how could what they say be relevant at all? Therefore, I can't really understand what they're saying. This is the problem. This is the problem. So this is just a revolution, you know, here. It's just happening right now. I didn't sit down to say anything about this. I just said, let me turn the camera on and see what comes up. But this is a revolution that has just happened. It's like the whole world's been turned upside down. How trying it must be for them, I would think, you know, wow, for all of us to be copying this attitude with them, to them, that we're superior to them, you know, that's... You know, I mean, I guess it doesn't bother them much, but I imagine it might... It might hurt a little bit. I don't know. Maybe I'm going to ask them. But I know in this world, when people cop a superiority complex to you, you know, it hurts, doesn't it? Like they're better than you. Like they're disrespecting you. Say, I don't really need to relate to you at all because I'm way superior to you. You know, people are feeling so superior to Jesus now, they're saying he's a myth. He's a myth. That just shows the superiority complex. Well, I can guarantee you that. Sriyananda Mahima is not a myth. It's not a myth. And neither is Longchenpa a myth, right? Neither is Longchenpa a myth. Very well known. Very well known in his time. And as was Jesus, very well known in his time. Very well known in his time. And the times now we're living in, that these are all myths, and if they're not myths, they just ignore them. You say, well, Jesus was a myth. Not in my mind, I know who she is. I don't care what you talk. I don't know. Pfft. Don't know. Whatever. Some lady, I don't know. So that's our superiority complex speaking. It's getting fed by all this, hey, I can take a picture and send it over there, you know, wow. We're a new people, we're a new age. We've left the old behind. We've left all those old archetypes behind. We don't need it anymore. We don't need Jesus anymore. That was fine back then, but we've evolved past that point, and now we're understanding that was just some sort of vestigial, archaic, you know, something that we needed, a mirage we needed to kind of, but now we know better. And there was no such thing, and on, you know, there's all this stuff. Superiority complex, and the world is so caught up in that. It can easily pull everybody into it, and everybody will lock their doors to these family members, you know, to these precious family members who embrace the one family without trying to be greater than it. We're locking our doors to them. We're locking our doors, actually. See, I don't want my doors locked to them, so I don't like what the direction the world is going in. You know, you can't live with that. You know, it just bothers my conscience. And so I'm scared of the direction the world's going in. They're going to insist that we all keep our doors locked, right? And Jesus comes knocking me and say, hey, no room here, no place here for you. Go somewhere else, not here. So, cat's out of the bag. I've just, you know, opened it up here and, you know, explained it's, we got a superiority complex. Totally unjustified, too. Totally unjustified. So we might as well start shedding that superiority complex and coming in touch with these, our great friends, our great family members, actually. And accepting, you know, the one family that is. So, I'll invite all my friends to come visit me. You know, come visit me. Absolutely. And just ask if they can't possibly put up with my boorish attitude, you know. And I just admit it, I have a terrible attitude, you know. Boorish, snobbish attitude towards you. I'm very sorry that I'm this way, but I'm willing to, you know, if you can put up with this horrible attitude, I'd be happy to have you, you know, come visit. You know, look at it that way. And can you please overlook my, you know, obvious gaffes, you know? Because for sure it's going to be there, right? For sure it's going to be there. And just can you accept me with all this, you know, nastiness, you know? Can you, as a starting point, you know, can you accept that as a starting point? And I'll try and, you know, get over this. Can you help me get over this? And if you just be honest like that, then I don't think you'd be mortified, you know, I don't think so. I just, if you tell them, look, this is the way I am, and they accept that you that way, then I don't feel there's a problem, you know, it's, you've been honest with them. And if they accept you, they say, okay, they're not mad at me then. They you know, I said, hey, I'm this is the way I am. And you said, okay, I'm willing to come visit you anyway. You say, oh, thanks so much. Because, you know, you may like yell at them, say, get out, what are you doing here, get out. And then they leave and say, oh, what did I do? You know, I told them to get out, that's so horrible. And they say, don't worry, we understand that you can lapse back into this irascible superiority complex, and it's okay. We're not, you know, you warned us ahead of time. We understand, so it's not a problem. So, wow, I'm so sorry. Can you come back, please? Okay. So it's honesty. It's honesty. This is the best policy. That's the best way to relate. Is just be honest about it. So, you know, maybe, this is a game changer. I've never seen this before because the world doesn't want anyone to see it here. Okay, the world does not want anyone to see it. They want to keep playing this game like, hey, you can't open this door. What's the matter? Jesus has locked this door. Hey, open up, Jesus, you know. Why is it locked? They don't take the time to look. There's a lock from inside. We're the ones locking it. Everyone's locking it. And it's not because we think we're inferior, it's because we want to keep Jesus out because we think that he's our swamp cousin, you know. Cousin from the swamp. And you know, we're gonna be embarrassed as someone finds out our swamp cousin is visiting us. Oh my gosh, you know. What's the matter with them? Don't they know better? It's like that. The attitudes we're copying in this world is just unbelievable, isn't it? Just amazing. And yet, it's true, we are copying these attitudes. So we need to get over ourselves. We need to repent and say, Jesus, I'm sorry. I truly am sorry. You know, and I can't guarantee you that I'm going to get over my attitude immediately. It's probably going to hang around for a while. So if you can, you know, possibly tolerate me, I'd be super appreciative of that. You know, I'm the swamp cousin with this crazy attitude. Yeah. So there you go. Paradigm shift. On the 27th of July. I said there'd be something great on the 27th of July. I said there'd be a paradigm shift. I said, I feel the 27th is going to be an incredible day. Okay. Here it is. Complete shift of attitude. Complete shift of perspective. And this legitimately opens the door for contact with our family members, our estranged family members, because we're really estranged from them. Make no mistake about it, we are estranged. We have done the estranging, okay? They're not estranged from us, we are estranged from them. We're blocking them. We don't want to be contaminated by them. We think that they're archaic. We think that they have accepted God as God is instead of trying to be greater than God. So, you know, we're the ones that are blocking them. So we're estranged, we've been estranged. Time to end that estrangement, okay? It's time to bring that estrangement to begin to reconcile. It's time to reconcile. That's it, 27th. I said, gotta get something major today. Here it is, just in time. I'll get it up. You'll have it there on YouTube the 28th. It's time to reconcile. It's time for the family to reconcile. Absolutely. The one family that consists of everything. All of reality is this one family. We're all family. That is a fact. All right. Let's see what happens now. I mean, this is just incredible what has happened here. Just incredible. And just go with it. Well, just go with it. Just go with it. If you can, just go with it. All right. We'll get going. That's it.